Here we go. Good evening, everybody. Welcome back to the Good Report. I know you're coming in. I gotta like share this thing out so that maybe we can have a few more members of our community tonight. Good evening. Welcome to the Good Report. It's good to see you. Let's see if anybody shows up tonight. You think that someone's going to show up tonight? We'll have to see. Is anybody going to be here tonight? If you're in the room, let me know that you're here by giving me a wave. If you're in the room, give me a wave. Welcome to the Good Report, a space where we gather every night to say what we're grateful for and to be in beloved community. I'm Andre in the flow. I'm just a guy. I'm just a human being just like you on a mission to spread love and positivity in any way that I can. This is the Good Report. Hey, Pam. I am having a good day. How are you doing? How was your day? What'd you get into? It was Sunday. Did you go to church? Where is my phone? Good evening, everybody that's tuning in to the Good Report. I promised that I would be here every night at 8:30 to hold space for gratitude and what's good in the world. If you turn on the news right now to any news channel, you're going to find gloom and doom and just awful things. Some of the things true, but still awful things. This is a space where we can talk about those things if we want to, and we can hold space, but we can also look and hold some element of the hope that we found today in our lives, and then hopefully that'll make room for the hopes of tomorrow. I'm sharing this out on my channels on Facebook, so just come in and get cozy if you want. If you want to catch it later, you can catch it later too. But this is a space where I decided that every night at 8:30, we were going to just focus our collective energy on something that's positive, man. We've been hooked up into everybody else's story all day. The numbers are rising. This person isn't prepared. Wear the mask. We've been tuned into that vibration all day long. But what about this one? What about the one of love and community? Someone's talking to me down here. Pam says she's okay just being lazy. Well, they did Facebook Live for church. Was the music good, or did they even have music at all? Let me drop this down so I don't have to yell over myself. Goodness me. Was the music good? Carrie, good to see you another night. Hey, Andre, hope you have had a good weekend. Almost missed it listening to My Favorite Murder. What is My Favorite Murder? Hey, Raquel. Margaritas are positive. Did you have your margaritas today on the rocks? Or did you have it in the blender? Oh, you're going to watch the second Guardians of the Galaxy movie. Is it out? I don't know. And if you're going right now, I love you, because people can go and come as they please here. This is just a space of collective positive energy. Not ignoring the bad that you heard today, but also every night at 8:30, deliberately setting aside a little sliver of time to be together and to share in light and love. Oh, Raquel said, in the blender, dude. There's no other... Good night, Pam. There's no other way, right? Oh, my God. It's a podcast where two girls talk about true crime. Oh, I see. I love you, Pam. Love to you and Scott. I'm so glad we've got to hang out. This is day 9 of this thing. We've been holding this kind of space together for 9 days. It's kind of wild when you think about it. Shall I shuffle the cards? I'm not sure if I can take another crime thing because I do consume a bit too much of that, like I Am a Killer and whatnot on Netflix. But, I'll check it out. I'll check it out. Oh, Raquel, I love and miss you too. I mean, you probably went from doing like everything and scheduling this meeting and that meeting. For those of you who don't know, I think I can say this out loud. Raquel is a publicist here in New York City. Like Samantha off of Sex in the City, darling. She, yeah, she's a publicist. And I'm sure that was pushing a lot of people around. And now we're all kind of at rest. For those of you who are watching right now, at 8 o'clock tonight, we started this Pulse program. The definition, I do not remember. But we started this Pulse program, and so now we're all in the house. We're told to be in the house and do not go anywhere. The only places that we can go are essential places like pharmacies and grocery stores, but still limit yourself 6 feet around you. We are too close in New York City. We're stacked. There's like 4 levels above me. Hold on. There's 1, 2. There's 3 levels above me. And each floor has like 5 to 6 to... Y'all know how apartments and cities work. It's kind of wild. What's the good word? Margaritas are good, especially when they're blended. What else is good? I gotta find these cards. Oh, there they are. Every night I've been pulling a card from the Book of Awakening. Uh-oh. Yeah, this is by Mark Nippo, who's an amazing inspirational poet and writer. You can check out some of his like legit interviews with Oprah. And I think what they've done is they've taken quotes from his book called The Book of Awakening and they've put it into like card deck form. And so every night I've been just shuffling these inspiration cards. Yeah, that's what they're called. This is day 9 of me doing this every night at 8:30. And I didn't know what they were called until right now. Right now, we've got people viewing and loving on us and sharing in our collective energy on Facebook, YouTube, Periscope, Twitter, and also on lovecityarts.org. All of you have gathered into this space, either now or in the replays or on the podcast or wherever you catch it, to hold space for love. Because perhaps you've been holding space for fear all day. I'm not saying that's a bad or good thing, you know? But we hold space in our day. In our 24/7, we hold space for a bunch of different things. And I feel that love should be one of them. And so if you haven't held love today, hold it now. And if no one's told you that they loved you today, I love you. Sincerely. Wherever you are and wherever you hear this. All right, I'm shuffling these cards now. Someone tell me by commenting on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, or lovecityarts.org, tell me when to stop. I'm just going to go with the first stop I see because I know there are people watching right now. All right, I'm going to wait. I'm just going to keep shuffling these inspiration cards until someone tells me to stop. And the one that's on the top is the one. Let's see. I'll just wait for the stop. I know you're out there. Someone just tell me to stop shuffling these cards. Come on. I'm going to stop shuffling these. These cards when I see a stop. Has there been a stop? And it just hasn't gotten to me yet.
Just tell me to stop shuffling these cards.
Maybe. Someone's gonna tell me to stop. Okay, thank goodness, Carrie. Holy moly. Jesus. All right. I guess they take a moment to get to me through the internet with this platform I'm using. Okay, tonight's car that I pulled right off the top, the moment that I saw the first stop, and then I saw the one right after it. This car tonight is know each other more fully. I gotta work on the lights in here. It's just too bright for... Anyway, the front of the card says, know each other more fully. I just can't get it to do... Anyway, that's what it says. The back of the card says, we create patterns that others depend on. And then the last thing we ever imagined happens. We grow and change. And then to stay vital, we must break the pattern we created. The challenge, which I don't do well but stay committed to, is to say to those we love, I am more than I have shown you. I am more than you are willing to see. Let's work our love and know each other more fully. I pulled a card like this before. I gotta read that again now that I can comprehend it. We create patterns that others depend on, and then the last thing we ever imagined happens. We grow and change, and then to stay vital, we must break the pattern we created. The challenge, which he says, I don't do well, but I stay committed to, is to say to those we love, I am more than I have shown you, and more than you are willing to see. I am more than I have shown you, and I am more than you are willing to see. Let's work our love and know each other more fully. Hey guys, that's what we're here for. I'm coming here every night at 8:30 until this thing is over. We're in day number 9. We are here gathered to know each other more fully, to work our love. Some of you are watching on the East Coast, confirmed. Some of you are watching on the West Coast, confirmed. Some of you are going into ER, nurse shifts right now. Some of us are going to roll over and watch a movie on Netflix. But we have all gathered, and those things are not the same, by the way. Shout out to all of the first responders. But we have gathered, and we will continue to gather every night at 8:30 and in replays to work our love and to know each other more fully. This is a good beat here. How are you efforting to know the person that lives above you more fully? I guess we can't really do that right now. We're quarantined. So like, how are you digitally with the World Wide Web finding out? Like, what's something you learned that you didn't know that you can share about somebody else? I'm thinking myself too. What did I learn? Well, listen, this is not in my friend group, but I learned that 100,000 people can go into an Instagram live and like catch the same vibe. The Obamas, both of them, Oprah, Gail, everybody, Ava DuVernay, Stevie Wonder, Quincy Jones, everybody was in that party last night. If you're not following D-Nice at D-Nice on Instagram, he starts at 5 p.m. every day. He's doing this amazing, what do you call it? They call it quarantine. It's like a quarantine party. And it happened last night. I think it happened to like 5 a.m. this morning, our time, but everybody was in there. I think it got to like 105,000 people all on that good vibe, like spreading that positivity. And all, I mean, we could talk about the celebrities being in there, but just think about the sheer numbers of people that were all on the same wavelength. It was really powerful. I'm not even trying to get 105,000. Hey, Stacia, it's good to see you. It's good to be with you tonight. You see how the vibe like changed a little bit? Yeah, it was a lot of people. It was 105. Mark Zuckerberg came in there, and the DJ was like, "Could you please tell your people to stop like shutting us down? They keep shutting us down when we get to, you know." And so Zuckerberg called somebody and was like, "Hey, they're trying to have this big party over there. Can we just make this exception? And then all of a sudden, like, capacity surged to like 105,000 people. And I was trying to like share that shit with the people I knew, and it was coming through, it's blinked on their end, and I had to like spell it out because the whole, like, all of Facebook started glitching at the same time as that Instagram live was going on. It was crazy. Like I said, I don't intend to ever, you know, who knows? Who knows how consciousness will raise? Maybe one day I'll have 105,000 viewers. I don't really care about that shit because the reason why we're here is what the card that I picked today says. We're here to know each other more fully. I feel like the reason why some of our, not to push blame, but because I'm the other and the other is me, but I feel like the reason why we are in this predicament is because perhaps we didn't know each other more fully. Yeah, there was a lot of groove power in there last night, Stacia. You could feel it. You could feel it in your own house. It was just something good about being in a room with people that were vibing on from that place. Celebrity on down, or celebrity on over, because I don't believe in that hierarchy bullshit. If you are human, you are enough. If you are human, you are valid. If you are human, your life has purpose. If you are human, you deserve to feel love. You deserve to feel love and acceptance. That is the only message I've got. It's going to get annoying because I'm going to keep saying it over and over again into the air. Sometimes it feels like no one who's listening. But you are enough. You are valuable. Like I said, your life has purpose. I'm so glad you're here. I think someone needs to hear that today. I'm so glad you're here. I'm so glad you're here with us doing this thing called life, not knowing what's going to happen next, not knowing if we're going to actually get a grip on this thing or is it going to take everything over, not knowing when we'll be able to actually hug a friend again. All of these unknowns. And yet, we still matter to each other. We do. And the reason why we're here is to say, I am more than I have shown you. Guys, you are more than you've shown me. Who's picking this up? Am I just kind of talking to myself? Am I on a cloud and not making sense? Let's work our love and know each other more fully. Wow, good groove. So good. To know you more fully. That's the tangent I was on. Part of why we're in this situation, and I know I keep beating you over the head every night with it, but part of why we're in this situation is we just refuse to see each other. We still refuse to see each other. We're locked in the house right now because we want to see each other, and that's love, but like we would hurt each other in the process. And so instead of like just chilling out, we got to be like, We gotta tell you, you can't go to the barber. We gotta make y'all look like Sasquatch. I've always looked like Sasquatch, but we gotta make y'all look like Sasquatch. So, you know, somebody on Twitter was like, I'm contemplating allowing my husband to cut my hair. As a gay couple, I'm contemplating allowing my husband to cut my hair. And Mother Nature, Mother Nature said, at you children of mine. You're going to know who's the boss. You're going to calm down. I'm sorry to this man for all of the loss and things like that, but we got to chill, guys. We got to chill. How are you chilling today? How are you chilling? I went into this game called Second Life. It's been around since like 2013, 2012. It's like an open world where you can create an avatar that either looks like you or doesn't. I'm not going to tell you my name because I could marry someone in there. I went to a dance party in there. I sound like a crazy person. No, but you guys know about like alternate realities, like 3D games, role-playing games, massive online things. So yeah, I was in there today. I won't tell you what my name is. You can go in there and try to find me if you want to. But I went to a dance. Well, first I went to the Botanical Gardens. There's no one there, which is odd. But imagine being able to experience a 3D real-looking Botanical Gardens by yourself, like on a private visit. That's what I did today. And then I teleported myself over to... Well, no. I didn't teleport myself that time. I actually walked across the street. Like, if you're not a geek or following, you're going to think I have... And that's all right. And that's all right. And that's all right. That's all right. Okay, so anyway, I crossed the street and I went to the club. And there were about 30 people dancing on the floor. Some of them had like names like their names were written in Russian, and some people were speaking Spanish in there. It was like 30 strangers in the digital space. I know I'm eventually going to go back to a club again once all of this is over. I love Soul Summit and my soul music. Let's see what these comments say. We'll get back to that, but right now I'm playing in digital spaces. Stacia says, tell me why I'm wearing a sexy ass leotard my mom gave me for nobody but myself. And I danced around and it felt so good. Listen, what did you dance to? What is your go-to? Hold on. Stacia's saying, what is your go-to private dance party song? Because I have a couple. I may play them in a second. Or at least pieces. I don't want to get shut off. Sometimes you gotta just get sexy for yourself and or lurk around weird video games and be... I was a bit of a lurker. I'm not gonna lie. I was a bit of a lurker. But it's Second Life. And so it's fun. I'm actually gonna look into some other ones. It kind of runs a little slowly and I've had others run a little bit faster. There's this game that I want to play... in the cloud. I'm gonna try doing that because sometimes the technology, the RAM and things, now is not the appropriate time to even talk about wanting more things, given that the universe is clearly trying to strip us down. I feel personally, and so I shouldn't talk about that MacBook that I want, but one day we'll get there. In the meantime, I'll have to just alternate the weird geeky games I play. Stacia says she still loves me. I love you too. It's the reason why I decided to gather here every night at 8:30 p.m. Eastern to share love with all of you. We have watched the news today. We have gotten on Twitter today. We've been on Facebook getting both real news and fake. Why not gather every night at 8:30 just for a few minutes? To just hold space for love. I don't think I've ever heard Kid Cudi's song Dance With You For Eternity. Let's see what it sounds like, shall we? I need a new song. Okay, here we go. Dance With You For Eternity. Dance With You For Eternity. I want to dance with you for eternity? Is it I want to dance with you for eternity? Google corrected me. Hopefully I don't make my computer crash by trying to do all of these things at the same time. Who's this by? Is it Kid Cudi? Dance. Okay, here we go. Okay. You didn't really make this as a request, but here we are. Dance for Eternity by Kid Cudi. Cudi? Could someone phonetically spell out how that goes? I don't even know. I'm not a cool kid like that. Dance With You For Eternity. Also known as... Oh, are you really going to drag right now? Here we go. This is Stacia's feel-good song. We're sharing it today. Is this a song, Stacia? Okay. All right. This is your put on my sexy leotard.
It's so hard to trust anyone. So this is awesome.
Like cutie. Kid Cootie.
You got me smiling, yeah, you're a lot of fun.
Kid Cootie. All right, fine. Whatever.
So this is awesome. I want to dance with you for eternity.
Oh, this is a really...
Like to see that body wet?
It's like a medium, like hey,
like
hey.
See that body wet? Let's make moments.
It's not like turn all the way up. It's like the medium, like the 7.5 good burn. Oh.
What a pleasure. Explore the moment, savor the moment. Our body.
Yes, Stacia, thanks for sharing this. Folks that are watching on Facebook, YouTube, Periscope, and Twitter, and lovecityarts.org, let me know what you think about this vibe, this bop. Hey. 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 Stacia, this is a good share, actually. Okay, and then you said, I do love you, and I mean the song, Hey Ya. Oh, yeah. No, we gonna keep this vibe. We're not gonna do that, Hey Ya. Because this is a good situation. Thank you, Stacia, for sharing your good report. Stacia's good report for the day was actually a pretty kick-ass song. This is Dance for Eternity. Dance the number 4 Eternity by Kid Cootie, who's got some really nice abs. I ain't gonna lie about it. Wow. Okay. And I'm back. I'm only human, and I've been stuck in the house for 9 days. Thank you, Stacia, for the share.
So this is awesome.
Let me know who you are and where you're watching from. I guess it tells us who you are. So let us know where you're watching from. Thank you, Stacia. Hey, hey.
What a pleasure, so much pleasure. Explore the moment, savor the moment. Our bodies.
So cool.
You're excited. I can feel you dripping.
All right. They're already going to mute my shit. So I should, yeah. That's going to be a giant blank piece in my. Yeah. Thank you for that, Stacia. Like, that's a moment. That's a moment right there. Literally, we've come to a place in our technological age where Stacia can tell me the song that she was in booty leotards. She can tell us what song it was. I can go look it up, and then we can all share it together over multiple states. This is just like, it's so weird. It just feels strange because like, it's like what they said in that book. It's the best of times and the worst of times. Like, people are, well, y'all know what's happening. I'm not gonna do that, but all of that, and here we are sharing together, which is the only reason why I push start streaming. Not for me, not for my ego, like Stacia and I've been talking about on our other projects. Not for the claps. For community, because scripture says, if you will, just bear with me for a second, where 2 or 3 are gathered in my name, I am in the midst. Which means that yes, all the world is a stage, and as 2 or 3 gather on that stage and bond together in love, more love enters into the midst. I know this is a wild interpretation. Some people are like, oh, he's gone off into a crazy place. No, no, no. Look, the book said, where two or three are gathered in my name, I'm in the midst. I believe that God is love. Love is God. So we're really talking about love. Where two or three are gathered, love is in the midst. So I'm not doing this for 3,000. I'm doing this for the one, the two, or the three who wants to gather in the midst of love. What greater pursuit is there than to be on a direct pursuit, an intense pursuit of love? What else matters? Yes, Carrie. Yes. It's just that simple. We think we need 2,000 people or like 3,000 people to follow us. We think that we need 200 people. We think that we need 20 people or 30 people in a space, you know, so that we can do something. That scripture was very like clear. It's one of the clearest ones out there. Where two or three are gathered in my name, I'm in the midst. And so right now, wherever you are, and I believe this includes podcast listeners. If you are in the midst, because we have gathered, love is here. Because we have gathered, love is here. Love is in the midst. Can you give yourself a moment to feel that? Just feel that. Just feel that love is in the midst. Carrie also has, I walk by faith and not by sight. Yeah. Just rest in the love. And you're right, Carrie, that the love that you feel, if you allow love into your heart right now, if you allow love to like push out, okay, so maybe you're cruising at like 51% fear and 49% love. Maybe that's where your gauge is in your car. I'm not talking about like my car or your, I'm not comparing cars. I'm just saying like wherever your gauge is, you know, and maybe your gauge is at 51% fear, 49% love. And because we are gathered, you now get an extra portion of love. And putting that in your tank will bring down the fear. So maybe you can go then to 51% love and 49% fear. I'm gathering here every night with all of you to fill up the love tank. What have I said? I've been saying this since the day that we started gathering. More love, less fear. More love, less fear. More love, less fear. More love, less fear. And then Stacia comes through because Stacia and says, I am 64% thirsty. And I don't think you're talking about drinks. 64% thirsty, 36% love. Child, put more love in it because you may not be able to get your thirst quenched. I'm thinking about that too. I'm like, how am I going to go this long without? That is the realest sip taken around the internet right now. I really don't know how I'm gonna go that long without. Hey guys, if you want to come on and like chat with me a little bit about all of this, I'm open to it. Just text me at 404-585-1278. 404, I choked too, Carrie. 404-585-1278 is the number. Come out wherever you are. If you want to come on and just like chat with me for a few minutes, we won't take a long time. But if you want to chat, text me and be like, I'm down, and your name. And then it'll come right here to me. And then, oh man, we can chat if you want to. But yeah, listen, I understand the thirst. I understand that it's very real. For those of us who don't have live-in dildos, because let's just face it, some of them are. But I digress. For those of you who don't have that type of situation, those of us who don't have that type of situation, this is just a drought. This is a drought. It's a drought. This is just a drought. It is the epitome of sorry to this man. It's kind of crazy what's going on right now. There are times, guys, I gotta admit, I don't know if you feel the same way. Chime in if you do. There are times when literally I'm like telling someone else what I just heard, and I'm like, this is not happening right now. Like I almost want to like look at my phone and be like, you know, did I just take one puff too many and then end up in this weird like sleep dream state where like, you know, I really don't know if, you know, this is real or imaginary. But then I open my phone and I type in the website of like one of my favorite news places. I type it in and I hit that, and literally there's a coronavirus dashboard. Like this is real. It's been like that. I gave you a bit of a long explanation of what it's been like, but it's been like that for nine days. But here's the deal. We're not going to lose faith, hope, and love. Faith, hope, and love. We're not going to lose it. We certainly are not. We're going to gather as much as possible, sometimes here, sometimes not, wherever you want to be. We're going to gather and concentrate our energy for just a moment on faith, hope, and love. Someone's got to do it. I know that there were a lot of preachers, and I'm not one of those, despite my delivery. There are a lot of preachers that did their first live streams or serious live streams today. I wonder how that went for them. But I hope that their message, I really do, was not for the purpose of getting tithe or offering or the church Cash App or Venmo. I hope that what they were holding space for was a little more faith, a little more hope, and a little more love. A little more faith, a little more hope, a little more love. That's all. That's what we gather for. I want to wrap this up soon, but for those of you who are watching right now, I want you to know that I love you. It may feel strange. I may not have seen you or heard from you in a month of Sundays. I may not have seen or heard from you in 10, 12, 19 years. Don't matter. I love you. And I'm sending you and your situation, your specific situation, all of the love I can muster. And the reason why I'm showing up here every night at 8:30 Eastern on all of these different channels that we're streaming on is not for my ego. It's not for me. It's so that we can hold on to faith, hope, and love. See, everybody ain't got it like we got it. Everybody ain't swimming in a bunch of people around them that care about them. Everybody didn't have a home to go to. Everybody didn't have like somebody that like is thinking about them today in the midst of coronavirus. Everybody doesn't have that. And so I'm thinking about how I can like connect with the people, with all of you. I'm grateful, but all of you and people like that really scrappy nursing home bound granny with the foul mouth, because that's going to be me. Who's like, I just need somebody that's like, I need something to listen to, baby. And so we'll be there. If they want it or they not. If they want it or not. Let me wrap this up. I'm going to read our card that we picked one last time. The card of the day on the Good Report, where we gather to hold space for light and positivity, love, hope. The card for the day that we pulled is Know Each Other More Fully. We create patterns that others depend on, and then the last thing we ever imagined happens. We grow and change. And then to stay vital, we must break the pattern we created. The challenge, which I don't do well because I try to stay committed to it, is to say to those we love, I am more than I have shown you and more than you are willing to see. Let's work our love and know each other more fully. Let's work our love and know each other more fully. Wow. Well, that is that on that. I hope that wherever you are in the world that you feel loved. Like I said, I'm going to come here every night at 8:30. What else am I doing? So why not hold space for people? Why not love on you and let you love on me? Know that I love you. Know that I'm holding you in my heart. Know that I'm just as freaked out as the rest of you, but I know that together we're going to be all right. Okay? Have a great night wherever you are. Know that you are loved, you are whole, complete, and you are enough. Talk to you soon, everybody. Have a good one.